Hi, my name is Logan Blair, and I'm a life science student studying ecology and evolutionary biology and forest conservation science.
Hi, my name is Jake. I'm a life science student studying chemistry and neuroscience.
Hi, my name is Sarah, and I'm studying chemistry and math, and these are our tips and tricks for course enrollment.
In my first year, I took the standard biology, chemistry, physics, and calculus, but that left me room for one full credit during my whole academic year that I could just take an elective for whatever I wanted. Not only was able to get a different sort of mindset from my biology and calculus that I had going on as well, but getting into the art side of things and a more creative expression aside from, cells.
So one of my first tips and tricks is to not plan to have a class immediately after a lab. So lab courses can actually run to be 4 to 4.5 hours long. And that whole time you're standing up, you don't get a chance to eat. So you're often very tired, very hungry afterwards. And it's a really good idea to have kind of a buffer time to just sit and relax after lab before you have to go and concentrate hard in class again.
When you're considering taking an elective in your first year, you're going to want to make sure that you're going to be interested in it. If you take a breath requirement that you might not like and you're just doing it to get out of the way, you're not going to like your schedule and you're not going to pay enough attention to it. And there are tons of breath courses out there, and there's something you can find that will be interesting. And it also gives you a chance to think about things from a different angle, because a lot of times breath courses are nothing like life science courses. And it's actually fantastic to think in a different way when you're used to just thinking and using the scientific method all day. So make sure that you're interested in it and really embrace it, because it's your opportunity to think differently.
A really good idea when you're planning your courses before first year and before any other year is to have a backup schedule. So on the day of course enrollment, you get a start time and you log on then, and sometimes the courses that you need are already full or the sections that you need are already full. And while this is unfortunate, it's not the end of the world. The truth is, there's a lot of switch around in the first couple of weeks of classes, and you really don't have to worry about not getting into a course right away. You'll often be put onto an electronic wait list, so you'll be basically standing in line electronically to get into those courses, and so when someone drops out, you're automatically moved up in the waitlist or even moved into the course.